Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today I'm going to be doing a neutral everyday makeup look. It's kind of like the look that when you want glam but you want something a little subtle, this is definitely your go-to. I'm going to be using the Benefit Porefessional Primer all over the face. Next up is to take the Soft Ochre Paint Pot from MAC. Mine broke, so it's a little on the dry side, but I still managed to use it and it worked out pretty well. We're just gonna go ahead and apply this all over the lids so we can have a nice canvas for our eyeshadow. For today, I'm going to be using the Violet Boss Allure Lee palette, and I'm going to be taking the shade Basic that's up at the top left corner. This is just going to be to set the soft ochre that we already applied on the eyes, and this will also help us blend the neck shadows really smooth. Is Britches. I'm going to be using the shade all over the crease and intensifying it to build the color up. And also, I listed all makeup brushes and all makeup products that I use in this video down under the description bar. Blending any harsh edges out. I took a clean brush with absolutely no product on it to blend out the outer crease, make sure that I have no harsh lines, and I have no idea what I was looking at, but just make sure that the crease is well blended, especially if you want to achieve a nice soft crease look. Alright, to deepen up the crease, I'm going to go ahead and blend in Alabama. I believe I pointed to the wrong shade, but it's Alabama. I'm going to go ahead and blend this in to intensify the look even more. And you guys can build this up basically to your liking. It doesn't necessarily have to be how I'm doing it. I'm going to be taking the shade Sugar, and I wish that I actually intensified this shade with like Fix Plus, but it ended up coming out kind of too sheer. I wanted some more sparkle in my life, so I'm just going to pack that on to my liking and blend and pack on. Onto the face, I am going to be using L'Oreal True Match Foundation in the shade W4. I'm going to be using a damp beauty blender to apply it. And FYI, this is my absolute favorite foundation. It's drugstore, it's affordable, and the finish it gives me is amazing. Not only that, but it's really important to work the foundation into your skin and take your time with it. That also helps you have a really, really smooth photo finish. Now for highlight, I'm going to be using the NARS Creamy Concealer. I'm first going to use custard and then vanilla right on top of it. I like to use vanilla more in the inner corners under my eye just to brighten that spot a little more. I like a nice bright under eye, but I don't like it too bright, so I like to just add that custard at the bottom first and then the vanilla. blend that concealer out, I'm going to go ahead and use my damp beauty blender and really work that under the eye, as well as on the bridge of my nose, my forehead, my chin. I really like to get those products well blended to prevent creasing. Set my under eyes, I'm going to be taking the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. This is one of my favorite powders to set under the eyes. It's so bomb, you guys, like, I love it. While my highlight is baking, I'm going to go ahead and take the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Palette. I'm going to take the two lightest shades and start carving out my face. Go ahead and remove that powder. As I remove the powder, I'm just gonna go ahead and blend the contour a little bit more because you can tell that it's a bit too harsh. So for the cheeks, I'm gonna take the Cheekathon palette and I'm gonna take the shade Coralista. And I just have to let you guys know that Coralista is my all-time favorite blush. I probably use this blush more than any blush I own. I swear by this blush, you guys. Like, it's just so, it's nice and shimmery, but it's not too pink. It's not too peachy. It's, I feel like, the perfect shade of blush. So the next step is highlighting, which I think is every girl's favorite step when applying makeup. I'm going to take MAC Old Darling and I'm going to be applying it with a large fluffy fan brush. I'm going to go ahead and take the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder again on a damp beauty blender to carve out my contour and make it nice and sharp. Taking any fluffy brush, I'm just going to go ahead and dust off the powder. And as I dust, I like to blend it out as well because I want a nice precise smooth line. I don't want nothing too harsh. That's good. Off the top of my head, I really can't remember what eyeliner this is, but any nude eyeliner will work. And like I said, I will have all products under the description bar. And I really liked how this nude liner really did brighten up the look a little bit. Taking my Roller Lash Mascara by Benefit, I'm going to coat my own lashes. I decided to stay away from falsies for this look because I wanted something very light on the eyes. I didn't want to make this look any heavier with lashes. Lashes do tend to give you that really glammy look, so I decided to keep my eyes a little more on the natural side today. For my lips, I'm going to be doing a combo with ColourPop and Kylie Cosmetics. I'm going to use the Chi Lip Liner by ColourPop with a collaboration with Kuichi, which I'm obsessed with. I love this liner. To top off this look, I'm going to be using Kylie Cosmetic lip glosses. I'm going to use the shade Like and Literally. I'm going to use Like all over the lips, and then I'm going to top it off with Literally on the center, just to brighten up the center of the lips a little bit. Alright guys, so this is the final look. I didn't realize that my camera was cutting off my forehead, but if there's anything that you guys would like me to film, please go ahead and comment down below. And please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys next time.